Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Future Friday. In today's episode, we're going to take a look at Gravitricity. What does that mean? Gravity powered battery. So let's dive right into it. Now, why there is a need for a giant battery for our grid is very, very simple. It's that power demand changes. Let's say you are running a coal power plant or a hydropower plant. You have 1500 megawatt power output. Okay, everything is fine. This is what we call as base load power. Now, but your demand will fluctuate a lot. So you can have a scenario where during nighttime your demand is very low, and then your demand starts to rise. It exceeds what your power plant can provide during the peak time, and then it goes back down. So during this time, we utilize what we call grid storage. So during the time of low demand, we store energy, and during the high demand, we sell that energy. So this is why we need it. And on top of that, this is just for our existing infrastructure with your hydro dams, with your coal power plant and nuclear power plant. We also have to take into consideration that renewable energy that we want to use more and more, simply because it's now becoming cheaper, it's basically not 24/7. So looking into solar energy, you can check my video here. So this is why there is an absolute need for a technology that allows us to store large amounts of electricity. So your first thought would be battery. Now problem is, batteries are what we call chemical batteries. Now, what does this chemical battery mean? Meaning, electrical charge is converted into some form of chemistry. Basically, there is electrical energy, electrical potential comes in, and chemical changes happen. So basically, there is a format conversion. So that format conversion inherently makes it slow. On top of that, it also degrades the battery itself. So it does not matter whether you have lithium-ion batteries, flow cell batteries, lead-acid batteries, it will over time degrade. Like, and I don't mean degrade as in like, okay, 3-4% degradation. It would be like 1% degradation every year, and then over 5 years, then its degradation would be like 3-8% degradation. So due to the chemical nature itself, not only it loses efficiency, it's like that efficiency over time drops. So this is very, very problematic of chemical batteries. Then we come to the aspect that it is very expensive. So let's say you can manage it. Let's say you somehow can afford lithium ion batteries. If you try to buy lithium ion batteries that is needed for, let's say, grid scale storage, as in hundreds of megawatt, not 10 megawatt or 20 mega, hundreds of megawatt, I'm talking gigawatts hour. Yeah, it's just too expensive. You're gonna go broke. On top of that, we, as of this point, as I'm making this video, there is no battery power storage that exceeds hundreds of megawatts. So flat out, it's not even large enough. So this is why we can't use normal, simple chemistry based battery. So do we have an option? Yes. Gravity is our friend in this regard. So pumped storage hydroelectricity is one of the oldest system, and we utilize this quite regularly. It is very powerful. I'm talking 2000 megawatt hour capacity. So it's very powerful and it is relatively cheap. Now, of course, you have to invest money into building the hydro pump and power plant, but it is relatively cheap at that scale. So all you can say is you will have generally a dam, and then you will put a reservoir on top somewhere, wherever you can. And then during your low demand, you're going to pump the water up. During your high demand, you're going to drain it. So basically charging it and discharging it. Many of these sort of plant and reservoir exist all around the world with different capacities. Some are 100 megawatts, some are 1000 megawatts, some are 2000, 10,000 megawatts is also under construction. So it is a very simple system. However, you can understand by looking at it, it requires insane amount of water, and it is very, very location specific. So yes, you can create it by artificially creating a height gradient, but it's going to be ludicrously expensive, and water is not available everywhere, and you don't need 100 liters for this, you need gigaliters for this. So even though this is very good, this is very specific in terms of location. Then we come to Gravitricity. I have no idea how to pronounce that. It's basically the idea of you're gonna take the water and you're gonna throw it away, and you're gonna replace that water with huge weight. That's all you are doing. It's the same concept. You are using gravity as your potential, but instead of using water, you are using weight. Basically, you pull up the weight, that is charging, you let it fall down, that is discharging. Pull up, charging, falling down, discharging. So that's all you're doing. So the power scale that they are aiming for, this company, I have provided a link down below, they are aiming for 1 megawatt to 20 megawatt power. Now you might be like, okay, don't we have thousands of megawatt power on the other end in terms of water pumped hydro? Yes, but again, this is one shaft that they are telling you. You can have hundreds of this. So it's up to you. And it does not require water. And in terms of efficiency, this is 80 to 90%, which is not amazing when you think about in terms of battery, but in terms of battery, you can't have 20-30 megawatt on cheap. So that is why you have to consider that, like 80-90%, and this have ludicrously long lifespan. This practically have infinite lifespan as long as you just keep replacing certain things that wears out. And it is in terms of like, once you start to build multiple of this becomes very cheap, because this is a mechanical system. How our trains, early trains used to be very, very expensive, very hard to build. Now we build bullet trains, Shinkansen, and TGVs on a cheap. So it happens. So once you, because this is a simple system, all you have is a weight connected to a wrench. Now that wrench is generally, we have this sort of technology. You can just go in the market and buy these. Only difference this time is that instead of a motor unit, also has motor combo generator unit. So during night time, let's say your demand is low, you push the power into it, it acts like a motor, pulls the weight up, that is your charging, and then you let it fall down during peak demands, that is your discharging, and then the cable rotates the wrench rotates the generator. It's very simple, it's one step, that's all there is to it. So depending on other things, this weight is basically your potential. Now you can use this company that is trying to build it. They want to use old mine shafts, because digging, they are not talking about 10 meter or 20 meter. They're talking hundreds of meter, bare minimum of 150 meter. So that's how it's working. It's basically you have a shaft, you have a weight that is going up and down. When it's going up, that is charging. When it's falling down, it's discharging. You're using gravity as a potential, and they are projecting lifespan of 50 plus years. And on top of that, it's never gonna like end or die. You're just gonna have to replace the cable or wrenches, because the weight is not gonna erode away in a sealed shaft, so nothing's gonna happen there. So it's a very long lifespan. So how do we determine the power or the capacity? Basically, power and capacity are two different things. Power means how many megawatts, and capacity means how many megawatt hour. Basically, kilowatt hour you must have heard of. So power would be determined by the fact of your weight. So let's say you have 10 tons, you have 1 megawatt. You have 100 tons, you have 10 megawatt. So weight will determine how much power do you have. So that's up to you. So let's say you need 50, 60 megawatts, you build the weight according to it. Either you have multiple small ones or some big ones. Now, of course, there is a limit. You can't have like 20, 30,000 megaton kind of weight. Even though we can build that weight, there is no wrench system that can safely handle that. So weight will be directly determining your power. How much power do you have? On top of that, the speed, like how quickly you are lowering it and how quickly you are raising it up, that will handle your peak power. This peak power is really useful for this kind of scenario, because many times, let's say grid have a very strong fluctuation. Let's say a stadium came online, or something very, very power intensive. Let's say somebody started turning on a giant metal furnace. So they have a very huge power draw. So whenever that happens, you need a lot of power and you need it quickly. So during that time, speed of the system, basically how quickly it's falling. Let's say it's falling at 1 meter per second. Okay. Let's say it can only give you 5 megawatts, but let's say it starts to fall at 20 meter per second, it's gonna give you a multiple of that power. So you're gonna get a lot of energy. It's gonna be a spike. So you want this, basically you don't want it to be like 30-40 meter per second, that's like supersonic reaching. So your peak power will be directly determined by the speed, how quickly you can safely pick the weight up and drop the weight down. So that will be your peak power. Now in terms of capacity, how long your battery is gonna last, in terms of like, let's say you're drawing a constant load, that will be directly determined by the depth, basically how deep this tunnel is or shaft. So the deeper the tunnel, the longer your battery capacity, the heavier the weight, higher the energy capacity, the faster your inches can go, the better the peak handling capacity. And we have all this technology right now. So this is the interesting part about this. We have been doing this sort of thing for mining operations, when we are pulling weights from very deep underground systems. So we know how to do this, and this is the power metric for that. So what can we expect in the future? Now this system is remarkably simple. I have already made a video about energy train, you can check out. That's where people want to use train as an energy storage. Now that is good system. That also bypasses the problem of water, because water is not available everywhere, and in large enough quantity that you want to dedicate it some amount of water in, like, you know, just for power storage. And water under pressure is very destructive. So this system uses gravity very effectively, and it is more dense compared to water, because obviously steel is denser than water. Or you can even use lead, whatever is cheap and effective. So the idea with this is, like, you're gonna have a town that's solely dedicated for this sort of system. You're gonna have one shaft, because digging shafts are very, very time consuming. So right now the drilling cost is very high, so you can't just go there and ask someone, hey, I want a shaft 150 meter deep. It's gonna cost you a pretty penny. So drilling cost has to come down first. Now, do we have the technology? Yes, we have done this for mining, but mining is kind of low-key right now, but we have the technology. We know how to do that. We drill one tunnel down, then you put a system of excavation so you can extract debris from down there, and then you drill another from bottom. So that way you can drill multiple tunnels very quickly, very cheaply. The first one will be expensive, first one will be slow, the second one after that would be very cheap. So drilling cost will go down once you start to build multiple of that. So the idea is basically you can have a field, or let's say you can literally put it where you have a lot of wind farm. Let's say that land is not used for agriculture. Next to a wind farm itself, you can put multiple of this. So there is a lot of future hope into this. And in terms of tooling requirement, like, you know, what kind of tools you have, it's very simple. This is why I'm in love with this idea, because all other ideas I have seen in terms of energy storage and all that, other than pumped hydro, because pumped hydro is basically a hydroelectric dam, everything else requires custom things, like flow cell batteries requires chemistry engineering and a lot of very, very complex tools. Lithium ion, again, lithium, and everything else comparatively requires magical level of technology. This is raw, this is simple. And the ventures that you need for this kind of weight handling, we have that. Like marine industry already uses wrenches that can pull, like, you know, 30,000 ton or 50,000 ton. So we have the technology, we just have to tune it. So I'm very hopeful for this technology. This is one of the best solution I have seen that can allow us to handle megawatt, you know, power storage. So this was my presentation on Gravitricity. I hope you liked it or learned from it. In that case, please leave a like. If you didn't, don't worry about it. You can dislike it. I would urge you to press that dislike twice. You can also leave a comment because I reply to all of them. Press the subscribe, press the bell icon if you're free, and as always, click the ads on the video, and thank you.